Hello, this is Adolf. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of design of steel structure. We already covered riveted connections and their problems in the unit 2. So in this video, we are going to see the welded connections. The content of this video lecture is we see introductions, advantages and disadvantages, permissible stress, and what are the types of weld and their symbols. Let's start with the introduction. In steel works, welding is used to join metal pieces with the application of heat, but without any pressure. We are applying heat only, we will join the two members. But we are not using any pressure on it. So if you want the metal pieces to be joined, the metal weld are heated around 2000 degrees Celsius to a molten state by an electric arc. This is the electric arc, and this is the electrode, or we call it as a weld metal. This weld metal will be heated around 2000 degrees Celsius. So it will get into a molten state and it will be applied in the joint where you have to use, and we will allow them to cool. During this, we will form a fusion weld in the metal surface. The temperature in the arc is around 500 to 8000 degrees Celsius. And the temperature at the steel surface is around 2000 degrees Celsius. The welding process are classified into two types. One is fusion process, second one is pressure process. This fusion process is popular in steel structure, whereas the pressure process is popular in mechanical assembly. Under the fusion process, we have two types. One is electric arc welding or metal arc welding, also known as metal arc welding, and gas welding. So this gas welding is limited to sheets or plates or tube having thickness less than 6 mm. But in the steel structures, we will use greater than 6 mm thickness of sheet, plate or tubes. So this gas welding is not suitable in the steel structure, and this gas welding produce low rate of heat. That's also we are not using this one in the field of steel structure. And this pressure process, we already know this is used in the mechanical assembly, not used in the steel structure. Under that pressure process, we have two types. One is electric resistors welding, another one is force welding. The advantages of the welded joints. As no holes are required for welding, the structure members are more efficient in taking load, because we are not providing any hole in the member. So the structure members are more efficient in taking load. The load or stress in a member directly transferred to the other member. We are not using any rivet or a bolt to transfer the load. The metal will automatically transfer directly into the other member. The overall weight of the structure steel required is reduced by the use of the welded joint. The welded joint are often economical, as less labor and less materials are required to do the welded joint. The erection or the fabrication will be done in lesser duration. Due to the welding, the member will fail in yielding because of the absence of a rivet hole. So the yielding failure, it is not a sudden failure. So the welding connection is not a sudden failure. It won't fail at a sudden. Weld connections are airtight and watertight. So it is popular in oil storage tank, water storage tank, and most in ship construction. These weld connections are rigid connections so that the member, the moment and deflection will be lesser. So these are the advantages of the welded joints. Next is the disadvantages of the welded joints. It requires skilled labor and electricity to do the welding work. And due to the sudden changes in the sudden changes in the temperature, member is subjected to internal forces so that the elongation will be higher. If the elongation will be higher, the weld will be fail. And the weld connections are brittle in nature. We can easily break that. So whenever it is subjected to very dynamic loading, the weld will fail faster than the riveted connection. Some the presence of air pockets or some voids are presented in the welded connections reduces the strength and efficiency of the connections. And these type of defects are not easily identified. We need non-destructive test to identify these type of defects. It will cost higher. So these are the disadvantages of the welded connection. Permissible stress in weld. The permissible axial stress in weld, sigma TF is equal to 150 Newton per mm square. Permissible bending stress in weld, that is sigma BC is equal to sigma BT, is 165 Newton per mm square. And permissible shear stress in weld is tau VF is equal to 105 Newton per mm square. These are the permissible stress of weld done in the shop fabrication. If you are going to do the welding on field, then the permissible stress are reduced by 20%. From 100, it is reduced to 80%. So the permissible stresses for the field will be the axial permissible axial stress will be 120 Newton per mm square. Permissible bending stress in weld on field will be 132 Newton per mm square, and permissible shear stress in weld on field, it will be 86.5 Newton per mm square. If we consider wind plus earthquake, the permissible stresses are increased by 25%, that is 1.25 times. It increased. So the permissible stresses for the weld is the permissible axial stresses increased from 152, it is 187.5 Newton per mm square. Permissible bending stress is increased from 165 to 206.25 Newton per mm square. and the permissible shear stress in welding is increased from 108 newton per mm square to 135 newton per mm square. So these are the permissible stresses in the weld based upon the field application, or we are considering the wind or the earthquake load. Next is, what are the types of weld in the steel structure and what is their symbol? If you are going to use the fillet weld, the section will look like this and the symbol is right angle triangle. If you are going to use square butt weld section, the section will look like this and the symbol is this one. If it is a single V butt, section will look like this one, like a V shape. So the symbol is also like a V one. Double V butt means both the sides we will have a V shape. So the symbol will looks like a cross, but it's actually a double V. Symbol is double V. And the single U butt is, the section is like this. Instead of V, the bottom it will have some shape nearer to U. So such symbol is will be U and we will have a line over it. And the W section will look like this. Section will be like W's. So the symbol is also double U. The single bevel butt. Bevel means some sloped. See here, it is sloped. From the end, it is sloped. In fillet, it is not sloped, but bevel it is sloped. So the symbol is also be like sloped one, and the double V it is. Single J, it is like a J joint. So symbol is J and double J bolt. So these are the types of weld available and these are the symbols. Next is classification of welds. Based on the type of weld, the welds are classified into four types. The first one is fillet weld or lap weld. Second one is butt weld or groove weld. Third is slot weld. Fourth one is plug weld. This fillet weld or lap weld is used when two members joining in two plane or angle. So two members joining in two plane, we will use the fillet weld. Butt weld or groove weld, we will use two members joining in one plane, we will use the butt weld. These slot weld and plug welds are used as a supporting weld to the fillet weld. These are the supporting weld to the fillet weld. So these are used to, these slot weld or plug welds are used to minimize the lap length because fillet weld require more lap length for larger load. So we will use the plug weld and slot weld for the support of fillet weld. So in this video we covered some of the basics of the welded connections. In the upcoming video we see the design of fillet weld and butt weld in the upcoming videos. Thank you.